In today's session, we are going to discuss about the master detail and how can we implement the master detail associations and the many to many and the various observations we'll see practically today. Now, so now in order to map the association between the two objects, first of all, we need those two objects. We need to have those two objects. We need two tables. Then only we can able to map the associations in order to segregate our data into the multiple tables. Instead of storing inside a single table, we can store the data into the multiple tables. And whenever we need, we can able to fetch the data from the multiple tables and we can able to present to the user, or we can generate a report or whatever you want. Then how to map this master detail association? Now let's see. So in the previous session, we have discussed about the lookup association between the two objects. One is the hiring manager, and then we are having the position. For each and every hiring manager, we can able to allocate one or more number of positions to be used to recruit the candidate for the open positions available inside the organization. Now, so once the position has been available, then for this position, so many candidates are going to apply. If there is any open positions are available inside an organization, so many candidates are going to apply, because the people who are looking for the job, those people are going to be applying for the position inside the organization, so that the organization people can receive these profiles and they can able to have an initial screening. They will shortlist the profile, they will conduct some interviews, and they will hire the candidates. So for that here, now I would like to have the association between the position and candidate by using master detail. Okay. So I would like to use one more object, candidate, and between this position and the candidate, I would like to map master detail association. Now in this case, I am going to be discussing one more way of creating a custom object. I will show you an option which is purely a drag and drop. So already you are aware of how to create a custom object. We have to go to the standard navigation, like the setup menu, go to the build menu, click on create, click on objects, and then click on new button, enter the details, you can create the object. But now here, without using that navigation, how can we create an object? I will show you practically, which is with the help of the drag and drop option. Now, so before creating the object, first of all, we will have a list of fields to be used inside this object. So now if there is any position is available, for a single position, number of candidates are going to apply. Not only one, multiple candidates will apply, who are having the required skills and who are from different locations. So now here in this case, how can we map this association? Let's see practically. So now here, I would like to have an object, candidate object. In this candidate object, I would like to have some fields like I would like to have the candidate ID. For each and every candidate, I am going to be allocating one ID, which has to be get started by using CID-100001. So this is the starting of the candidate ID. Keep on, it has to increment the value by one. This is the format that I would like to use to generate that ID here. And the name of the candidate. So now this is a standard field. Why? Because is whenever I'm creating a new field, new object, automatically Salesforce is creating the name field by default, so that I would like to use this a standard field. The next one, candidate or location, which is a pick list. I'm going to specifying some values, like some city names I would like to populate. From which city the candidate has been associated. And then his contact number, which is of type a phone. Email ID, which is of type an email field. And his current CTC, now which is a currency symbol. His expected CTC, which is a currency type. His notice period. I am providing some options here, pick list. Like as this candidate may be an immediate joinee, or this candidate may require 1 week of time to join that organization, or 15 days, or 1 month, or 2 months, or 3 months. After that, nobody will accept, okay? If you are giving more than 3 months notice period, no company will ready to release offer to you. So this is the maximum. Nowadays, everybody is expecting the immediate joinees. They're giving maximum of 15 days, not more than that. The people who are ready to join within 1 week or within immediate or within 15 days, only those people are going to be looking for those candidates. If you say, I have 2 months of notice period, then the people are not scheduling the interview for you, because we are having that very hard requirements right now for the Salesforce. Because what happened is, even though if they're ready, if you have released that offer, so before releasing the offer, they're thinking, now you have 2 months of notice period. So now we are releasing the offer for you. So we are assuring you that definitely will be joining our company. So within this next 2 months, then what will happen? We don't know. So you may be getting one more offer, which is a very good package more than us. So at that time, you may be going to some other organization. So for you, we are waiting for 2 months. After 2 months, if you are getting some surprises, like, so if you are not going to be joining our company, it will be a very big problem for us. So that's what the people are not giving that much of time. They're giving maximum of 15 days. And after that, so I'm going to providing that information like, my technical skills. So now this technical skills, I am going to selecting the multi-select pick list. I am going to be using some multi-select pick list over here. Now, so now these are the various fields that we'd like to create inside this object here. Now, let's create this object by using the drag and drop option. How to create that? Now, let's see here. So now I would like to create this object by using schema builder. Okay, by using that schema builder. So now, I would like to create the object by using schema builder. So how to create the object by using schema builder? Now let me show you practically. Let's go to your Salesforce instance. Go to the setup menu. Go to the left panel. Go to the build menu inside the left panel. And inside the build menu, we are having an option called as schema builder. We have an option called as schema builder. Click on schema builder. Now the schema builder is going to be using to prepare the pictorial representation of my object which I'm having inside the Salesforce. It may be standard, it may be custom, and we can see the associations among those objects, the fields and everything. But now my requirement is, I don't want to see the existing object's structure. I want to create a new object by using this schema builder. Then how to do this one? Now let's see practically. So for that, just remove this object, existing objects on that schema builder. Click on clear all. Click on clear all link, which is going to be clearing all the checkboxes so that all these objects will be getting removed from the canvas. Clear all. Now the objects are gone. Now, I want to create a new object here. How to create the new object in Salesforce by using schema builder? Let's see here. Now, let's go to this particular left panel, which is an expand and collapsible panel. So where you are having two options are available inside this panel. This is a panel. Inside this panel, you will be having two tabs. This is the first tab, elements tab, and this is the second tab, objects. Two tabs are available here. So we have two tabs, elements tab, objects tab. Now currently objects tab has been selected so that it is populating all the objects information to you. But now in this case, I'm going for elements tab. Observe what will happen, what we have inside this. Now, so in the left panel, you will be having that elements tab, you will be having objects tab. When you click on elements tab, it is going to providing so many element types to you. Let's see what are those element types are available here. We are having object, there is an element type is available. We are having the field types, auto number, formula, roll up summary, lookup, hierarchy, master detail. And then we're having the field types like checkbox type, currency type, date, date time, email, number, all the field types are available. Nothing but here, these are the various elements has been given by the Salesforce to you, which are used to drag and drop and to create your custom object and the fields inside this. So that this is the second way of creating your custom object now. Then what is the difference between creating a custom object by using the standard navigation and creating the custom object by using this schema builder? We'll see the difference practically here. Now, I would like to create an object here. In order to create an object, you will be having an element called as object element here. Just a drag and drop onto the canvas. Okay, just a drag and drop, that's it. Now drag and drop. It is providing that a graphical user interface in order to enter the data to create a new custom object. So now here I'm entering the data, the label, candidate. The plural label is the candidates. I'm going to be creating the object with the name, the candidate, and the tab name is candidates. And then select that options, like as optional features, allow reports, allow activities, and the track field history. And then I need the notes and attachments related list as well. So now add Google Docs, notes, and attachment related list to the default page layout. Why? Because is whenever a candidate is going to be applying for a position, then after entering his details, he needs to attach his profile as well. Okay, he needs to add his profile as well here. So for that, in order to attach that profile, in order to add an attachment, we need these attachment options as well, so that we are having this. Now, whenever you are going for that options upon creating the object by using standard navigation, in the last section, you will be having two checkboxes. One is add notes and attachment related list. The second one is launch a new custom tab wizard after creating my custom object. Nothing but what will happen? It will be creating a tab for you. But do we have this checkbox over here? No. Nothing but the difference is, the first difference what we have observed is, upon creating the custom object by using the schema builder, it won't provide any tab for you. We have to create the tab manually. If I am creating the object by using the standard navigation, it is providing the object, it is providing the tab also by default in a single shot. But here tab will not be get provided to you here. So we have to create the tab manually. You know how to create the tab for an object, we'll see. Already we have discussed about that. Now click on save button. It is creating an object for you. So in that object, it is providing some fields, name field, owner field, last modified by, and the created by. The fields are available. So along with that, what we want some more fields, candidate ID field. Now, which is of type auto number. So that here go to the fields type and then just drag and drop onto the object here. In which object you would like to create the field, just you can drag and drop on that. Now it is providing that graphical user interface. Candidate ID. And this is an auto number field. So I'm specifying CID hyphen, the 6 digits. The starting number is some 400001. And if there is any candidate records are available, generate the auto number for that candidate records also, which are existing inside my object. So for that here, we can able to select this checkbox as well. Click on save. My field has been created here. The second field is, the next field is what? Location. Name field is a standard field which is available by default. So now, location field. Go to that location type, nothing but the pick list type. Drag and drop onto the object. Drag and drop onto the object. It is providing that option here. Location. Values are some Hyderabad. Some Bangalore, Chennai, Pune, Mumbai, Noida, Delhi, Kochi. These are the locations here. Select the checkbox sort values alphabetically because I would like to display these names inside that the alphabetical order, so that I'm selecting that sort option here. Make it save. The field has been created. The next one, contact number and the email ID. Contact number is a phone type, so that select that phone type. The contact number, I'm making it as a mandatory by using that required checkbox. Save it. And the email ID, I'm using that email field. Email ID. I'm making it as required. Next, I'm creating the PAN number field, which is a text type. PAN number of the candidate. So now the length should be maximum of some 10 digits, nothing but the 10 characters. So now I would like to make it as a required. Okay, I would like to make it as a required. Now, save it. I'm adding that passport number field as well. Passport number, which is also having some 10 characters. Now make it save. And the next field is current CTC and expected CTC. These are currency fields. I'm creating that currency fields. Current CTC, maximum of some 10 digits. Now make it save. And I'm creating one more field, expected CTC. So now this expected CTC, I'm going to be making it as mandatory because based on that CTC which he is expecting, we are going to be shortlisting his profile, whether we can able to offer that much of package or not. So based on that, we will go ahead. So for that here, I'm specifying that required. And then notice period. Notice period also, I would like to make it as mandatory. Notice period is a picked list type, so that I'm creating that notice period. For that notice period, I'm populating some set of values here. Like as immediate, 1 week of notice, 15 days, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. I don't want to sort the values in alphabetical order. I want to use in the same order. See. And after that, what is the next field? Technical skills. Technical skills, I'm using a multi-select pick list over here. I'm creating the object, I'm adding some values inside this, because I'm adding C programming, C++, Core Java, Advanced Java, J2EE, Microsoft.NET, C#.NET, ASP.NET, Oracle, SQL Server, SAP Basis, and SAP ABAP, and the manual testing, QTP, Selenium, LoadRunner, Salesforce CRM, Apex, Visual Force, some big data. Like that, I'm adding some values here. These values I'm going to be sorting in alphabetical order by using that sort checkbox. Now, so now the number of visible lines are some 5, nothing but at a time it has to display only 5 values to me. The remaining values you can able to check by scrolling down that scroll bar. Click on save. Now my object is ready. So with the required fields, whatever the fields are required, we have added all those fields inside that. Now, if you want to go to that object, just you can expand this pick list. Nothing but the small option is available. Expand that and go to that view object. Okay, go to that view object. Click on view object. Now we can able to see that object information. This is the candidate object which you have created. The API name is candidate underscore underscore C. And these are the fields which you have created inside this object here. We can able to see all those fields information inside that. Now, so now when you go to your tabs, you are not getting any tabs for this candidate object. Why? Because as already we have discussed that upon creating a new custom object by using Schema Builder, we don't have any ready-made option. Okay, we don't have any ready-made option to select the checkbox to be get created tab automatically. This is the first difference that we have observed. Now, the second one. So now I am going to be creating a tab for this object here. Okay, I'm creating a tab for this object. Now let's see here. How to create the tab for your object, candidate object. Let's go to your build menu. Go to the create and expand it. Inside that you will be having an option called as tabs. Click on tabs. I want to create a tab for my object. So that's go to the custom object tabs. Click on new button. That already we have discussed four types of tabs available in Salesforce. Custom object tabs, web tabs, visual force tabs, lightning page tab. These are the four types of tabs are there. So now in order to create a tab for your custom object, go to the custom object tabs section, click on new button to create a new tab. So now here, it is asking us to select that object name for which you are going to be generating a tab. And we can able to select the style for your tab. So what style that you want to apply for your tab. So now what image and what color as the background to be get applied for your tab. So we have to select the tab style. So now whenever you are creating the tab for an object, we can have only one tab, not multiple. Okay, not multiple. Even though it may be standard, even though it may be custom. For one object, only one tab. Nothing but object to tab, we are having only one-to-one association. Now, it is populating all those objects which has been created, which are not having the tabs inside this object pick list here. Select the object from the pick list and select that tab style which you want to apply for your object. So now select that pick list and expand it. It is populating candidate. So now this is a custom object. Previously, we have created three custom objects again, customer, position, hiring manager. Those objects are not populating over here. Why? Because those are having some tabs. But only the candidate object which is not having the tab so that it is populating that name. Select that object name. Select that tab style. Select that tab style. Which tab style that you want to apply. So now let's take any of the tab style, whatever you want. Okay, now. I'm going to be selecting the tab style like this boat. Okay, the boat tab style. Select that style. Go to the next button. And then make this tab to be get visible to all the profile users. Click on next. And make it save. So now the tab has been created. The tab has been added onto my tab bar. Now the tab is available on my tab bar over here. So that here we can able to use this tab in order to create the object. Now, if I'm trying to be creating the record, observe what will happen in this case. Click on candidates. When you click on new button, how many fields are visible? Candidate name, contact number, email ID, PAN number, expected CTC. These are the only fields are visible here. But how many fields I have created? So many fields I have created. These many number of fields we have. Then what about the remaining fields? Wait, it's not populating that fields. So now here it is populating only those fields which has been made it as mandatory. The optional fields are not visible on this layout by default whenever you are creating the object through schema builder. Then what we can do? How can we make those fields to be get visible onto my layout? So for that, we have to go to the page layout customizations. Inside the page layout customization, we can drag and drop those fields onto the layout so that we can display those fields as well. So now, let's see. This is the second difference. Let's go to that view object. Go to the page layout. This is the page layout that we have for this object. Click on edit link. You are aware of how to customize the page layouts that already we have discussed. Now, let's go to that object here. See, when coming to my fields are available inside my layout editor. But these fields are not visible to you on that page layout. Why? Because these are not mandatory here. So whatever the mandatory fields are there, those mandatory fields are visible to you on the layout. Remaining option fields are not visible to you by default. So that we have to make it as mandatory by our own. Or we can able to place those fields to be on the layout by our own with the help of page layout customizations. Now, how can we display those fields? Just you can drag and drop those fields. But before drag and drop, I would like to add some sections. Now add the sections here. I'm adding the section. I'm adding a section called as compensation details. Inside this compensation details section, I would like to place the compensation related fields. Like as I would like to place that the current CTC field, and then I'm placing that expected CTC field. And then after that, I'm placing one more section here. So now this section is the contact details section. Inside this contact details section, I'm placing those fields, like as the contact number and the email ID. Next, I'm placing one more section. Additional information. Additional information section, where I'm displaying the fields in two columns. Inside this place, I'm placing that fields like the PAN number and the passport number. PAN number and the passport number. And then I'm adding one more section, that is the technical skills. Technical skills section, I want to place only the technical skills related field, so that I need only one column here. Click on OK, place your field, technical skills. And then we are having few more fields are available. Candidate name is there. I'm placing that location. I'm placing that notice period. And then I'm placing the owner field and the candidate ID field over here. This section has to be get visible in both the layouts, so that I'm selecting detail page, edit page both also. When you come to the down system information, I want to display nothing but the created by, last modified by has to be get displayed in the both the layouts as well. When you come to the activities, I don't want all these activities. I'm removing that activity history also. I don't want, just I want the attachments option in order to add some profiles, in order to upload the profiles as well as an attachment, so that I'm adding all these options here. Now let's click on save. Now your layout is ready. Click on candidates, click on new button. Now we can able to get those fields information inside this. We can able to see that sections, information section, contact details section, compensation details, additional information, technical skills section, all the things are available to you over here. So now we are having these two objects. Both objects are ready for me right now. Let's go to your Salesforce instance and go to the schema builder. Inside the schema builder, I would like to display these two objects, or the three objects which we have created as of now. Like as I'm displaying that hiring manager, my position object and the candidate. So now I'm placing this candidate object over here. So these are the three objects are available right now: hiring manager, position, and the candidate. Between this hiring manager and the position, we are having that lookup association from position to hiring manager. Now I would like to map the master detail association between the candidate and the position. So why? Because is whenever if anybody wants to apply, if any of the candidate wants to apply for the position, then first of all, he has to select the position, nothing but select the parent, nothing but for which position he is going to apply. Directly, he cannot submit the profile. If there is any open position, then only I would like to accept the profiles from the candidates. If there is no open positions are available, then the candidate cannot apply. He cannot store their profiles into my database. So for that here, whenever you are going to be creating a candidate record, first of all, we have to select that position to which you are going to apply. Without selecting the position, we cannot apply here. So now, for that here, in between these two objects, I would like to map the master detail association here. How to map this master detail association? Now let's see practically here. Take that use case. Use case requirement. Configure Master Detail Association between position and candidate objects. So now tell me here, whenever you are going to be mapping the association between these two objects, the first step is we have to identify the parent and child objects. Which object is a parent object now? Parent object is what? Child object is what? Now tell me here, whether candidate is the parent or position is the parent?
Position is the parent.
Why position is the parent?
One position can have multiple candidates.
Yes, right, correct. So now here for a single position, multiple candidates can apply. Okay, for a single position, multiple candidates can apply. So for that here I'm making that one parent, multiple childs. Nothing but position is the parent and the candidate is the child. Now, we need to map that association between these two objects here. So in order to map the association between the two objects, what we need a common field. Nothing but we need a common column. So now here we have to create a common column. Where, in which object we need to create? In the child object always. So now, create a common column in candidate object by using master detailed field type, which references the position object, which is referencing that parent object here. Now, in my case, the parent object is the position object. So now let's see how to map the association between these two. So that mapping the association is nothing but simple concept, creating a new field inside that the child object, which is associating with that parent. It may be lookup type, it may be master detail type. That's it. Now, let's go to your Salesforce instance. Go to the candidate object here. Go to the view fields by using that first.com quick access menu. Go to the custom fields and relationships section. Click on new button. Select the field type as master detail relationship. Yesterday we have created the field of type lookup and we have discussed about the observations. Now I'm selecting master detail relationship type here. Select that field type as master detail. Go to the next button. Select the parent object to which it will be getting associated over here. To which object you would like to make it associated? Select that option now. So now to which object you would like to make it as associated for that position? Select that object as position. Go to the next button. Specify the field name here. Position name. So this is the position name for which the candidate is going to be applying right now here. So now inside this, you will be having some set of options are available here, like as read only, read write, allow reparenting. Nothing but what you observe with this option here, allow reparenting. Yesterday we have discussed about this similar kind of option there. Whenever you are having that lookup association between the two objects, then we can able to change the parent of a child record at any point of time. For example, if you have assigned a position record to a recruiter, if the recruiter is busy with some other task, he is unable to complete, he is unable to find out the resources, then we can assign the task to somebody else as well. Nothing but we can change the parent as well. But now in this case, allow reparenting, nothing but in order to change the parent of a child record, we have to enable this option by using this, by selecting this checkbox. But when coming to that, the lookup association, reparenting option is available by default, but in master detail, reparenting option is not available by default. But if you want to enable it, there is a solution that we have to select this checkbox allow reparenting. Then only this particular feature will be getting enabled for you. Okay, now. So now I am not selecting anything over here. We will come back to here again. Go to the next and make it save. So now we have mapped that association here. We have created a field with the name position name, which will be having that the master detail association with the object position. Okay, this is the association that we have between those two objects. So now let's go to your schema builder, refresh that user interface. Refresh this one, observe what will happen in this case. Now we are having the association. Now between hiring manager to position, we are having that the lookup, and between position to candidate, we are having master detail association. You will be having that master detail association is available. So now this master detail association is going to be representing by using this maroon color symbol. Here it is representing that the maroon color symbol is representing master detail association. Now these two objects are associated again. These are the three objects that we have. So now hiring manager to position and position to candidate. So now tell me here. So what type of association it has mapped, either one to one or one to many. Now whenever you are mapping that master detail association also. Now from the position it is starting like as one. When it reaches to the candidate, it is applying that many option. Nothing but one to many. Even though it may be lookup, it may be master detail. By default, it is going to be mapping one to many association by default. This is the first observation here. So now, in this master detail association, we did some observations here. Now let's see each and every observation one by one. The first observation. Master detail association provides one to many association among the records by default. Among the records by default. This is the first observation. Next, go to your records, go to the candidate, click on new. Observe that scenario here. Whenever you are going to be creating a new candidate record, candidate name, notice period, location, the other fields we can enter. But upon creating that record, compulsory we have to select the position. Because position field is a mandatory field, there is a red color bar symbol is there. Nothing but lookup field is mandatory upon creating a child record inside that master detail association. Nothing but upon creating a child record, compulsorily we have to select the parent. Without the parent, there is no child concept inside this master detail. But in lookup, without having the parent, we can able to create the child records also. That flexibility will be there. And but when coming to the master detail, without the parent, there is no concept of child. Now. So now for that here upon creating that candidate. For example, I'm creating a candidate here. Like as some Raghu P. So the notice period is from 1 month. Location is from Hyderabad. Contact number, I'm entering some value. Email ID, raghu@gmail.com. Current CTC is some 9 lakhs. Expected CTC is some 14 lakhs. PAN number, I've entered some value. And the passport number also I'm entering the same. He's having the technical skills. Like as. He's having the skills on Salesforce CRM. He's having the skills on Apex programming. He's having the skills on Core Java because previously he has worked on Core Java, and then he's having the experience on Visual Force. So these are the technical skills he is having, because as a single person, we can able to work on multiple technologies as well. So that I'm selecting that multi-selector pick list over here. Now, but I haven't selected any position. Let's click on save button, observe what will happen in this case. Now it is asking you to, it is enforcing you. Okay, it is preventing you to create this record because you haven't selected the position record to whom you are going to apply. Position means what? The parent. So that upon creating the child record, compulsorily we have to select the parent over here in this case. Without selecting the parent, we cannot be able to create the child record. So now select that parent here. Now click on position. It is populating the position names over here. Okay, it is populating the position names. So now here it is populating Java developer, Salesforce administrator, TIBCO developer, C++ developer, mainframe developers. Now, here I have a question. For example, assume that, come to my scenario. I'm having my positions where Java developers are available in two locations. I'm cloning this record again. This is also same Java developers. I'm having five requirements for the location is for Bangalore. For the location is Bangalore. Now click on save. Nothing but how many Java developer positions are available? Two records are there. This is also Java developer, this is also Java developer. The first record is for the Bangalore location, second Java developer position requirement is for the Delhi location. So now come to this particular object. When you click on this lookup, it is getting the Java developer's name here. But I'm looking for Bangalore. So which one is the Bangalore one? Which one is the Delhi one? How do we know? It will be very, very difficult to understand. Okay, it is very, very difficult to understand. Then what we can do? So now instead of displaying only the name, I want to display some other values of that position also. Like as what is the current status of the position and what is the location and then what is the close date. Everything I would like to show inside this table here. Nothing or what I want to do, not only the position name, I want to display the position location and then the open date, close date, number of vacancies are available, everything I want to show inside this table. This is what a lookup dialog. Okay, this is what a lookup dialog. So now here, then how can we configure this one? It is a lookup dialog of what, which object? It is a object of open positions object. So that go to that open positions object, nothing but it is called as the search dialogs or the lookup dialogs. How can we customize this lookup dialog? Now we will see. In this lookup dialog, it is populating only the position names. But not only the position names, I want to display the other details of the position also. Why? Because I am going to be applying for the Java developer. So now for here, we are having two records are there with the name Java developer. Which record do we need to select? Because this Java developer position is for Bangalore, one is for the Delhi. But now in this case, which one is for Bangalore, which one is for the Delhi, I don't know here. So for that, I want to populate some other values also here. Let's go to that position object. Go to the first.com quick access menu. Click on view object in order to customize that lookup dialog. Go to the down of your object. You will be having an option called as lookup search layouts. You will be having search layouts are available. So come to the section called as search layouts section. Inside the search layouts section, you will be having a dialog called as lookup dialog. You will be having lookup dialog is available here. In this lookup dialog, what is that column name? It is displaying by default position name. It is displaying that position name over here. But now, not only the position name, I want to display some other values as well. Then how can we display? So click on edit button here. Click on edit link. It is populating only the position name. I want to display the location for the position. And then I want to show the maximum pay which they can offer, number of positions, and the close date. And the position status. I want to populate these values here. Now click on save. Now we have customized that. When you go down inside the search layouts, if for the lookup dialog, we have added few many options here. Nothing but so many columns we have populated here. These are the column names. These column names you are can able to display over here. Now let's go to your candidate record. Click on that lookup icon. It is providing those values to you. It is populating the position name, location, maximum pay, number of positions, close date, position status. Now here you are having that clear information available over here. So now one is for the Bangalore location, second one is the Delhi location. I'm looking for the Bangalore location. So this is the first record. So let's select this record over here. So now, suppose if you're having some thousands of records are available inside your object, all those records will not get populated to you here. Then what we can do? At that time, we need to display, we can able to search for that record, like as some Java developer. Type some characters over here. Click on Go button. It is providing those records which are starting with the characters which you have entered over here. If you're looking for some Salesforce, SA, when you click on Go, Salesforce administrator record. Like that, we can able to search for the records as well. Now, Java records. I'm applying for the Bangalore location record, so let's select that record. So nothing but what we have observed, whenever you are going to be creating a child record inside the master detail association, selecting the parent is a mandatory field. Without selecting the parent, we cannot create a child record. Now click on Save button. Your record has been created over here. So this is the Raghu is the candidate here who has been applied for the position Java developer. Now make a note of this observation. Upon creating the child record, lookup field is mandatory. Mandatory. That is, we need to select the parent record upon creating a child. Upon creating a child. So this is the second observation what we did. Next, the third one. The position record has been, the candidate record has been created here. So now when you go to that position record, Java developer, how many candidates has been applied? We can able to list out that. When you come down, you will be having that candidates. How many candidates has been applied for this position? Only one, that is Raghu P. So now Raghu is the only candidate has been applied for this particular position, Java developer, which is for the Bangalore location. This will be taken care by Ayushi. Now, this is the way we can able to map the association. Now let's go to your candidate object here. Come to the child. So now here, for example, I have applied for the position that is Java developer for the Bangalore location. So now after that, I heard some information. Okay, I heard some information that the Bangalore positions are full. So now I want to apply for Delhi location as well because I need a job. So now I'm trying to be changing this one. From instead of Java developer for Bangalore, I would like to change it for the Hyderabad, for the Delhi location. When I double click on that, nothing will happen. Nothing but what happened, I'm unable to change that position record. Why? Because it is displaying like as a lock symbol to you. Okay, it is displaying like as a lock symbol to me. Nothing but what happened, I'm trying to be changing the parent. Okay, I'm trying to be changing the parent, but which is not allowing us right now here. So why? Because is here, when coming to the master detail association, reparenting option is not available by default. Okay, reparenting option is not available by default. If you want to allow the reparenting, then what we can do, upon creating that particular object, we have to select the checkbox allow reparenting. But in lookup association, reparenting option is available by default, but here there is no option available. So now, how can we enable this one? Now let's see here. Go to that field. Go to your master detail field over here, which is the field position. Click on edit. Upon creating the field, you will be having one checkbox called as Allow Reparenting. Select this checkbox in order to make the child records to be get associated with some different parents. Now select the checkbox, click on Save. Now go to that, refresh this user interface. Now when you press the mouse pointer, it is displaying like as a pen symbol, nothing but it is a writable, nothing but we can modify. Double click on that, field is in the modify editable format. Select that lookup, select the Java developer position for the Delhi location and make it save. Now I have applied for the Java developer position, which is for the Delhi location here. This is for the location Delhi. Now let's make an observation here. Reparenting option is not available by default, but we can make it enable by selecting the checkbox Allow Reparenting upon creating the master detail field. So this is the observation here. Next, the fourth observation. Next one. Assume that this is the record is available right now. The candidate. I am creating one more candidate record by cloning this existing one. So now his name is some Kiran Kumar. He is having immediate joining. He is from the Hyderabad location. His email ID is somekiran@somegmail.com. He is going to be applying for a position called as Salesforce developer. Salesforce administrator position for the Mumbai location. He is applying for Salesforce administrator. Now let's make a save. I am cloning this record again. I am creating one more candidate. So now here I am going to be creating a candidate record with the name some Sandeep. Sandeep Kumar, he is from some Kochi location. He is having 2 months of notice period. He is going to be applying for a position. He is applying for some tip code developer, which is for Hyderabad location. Now let's click on save. So now these are three candidate records are available inside my object here. So now the candidate name is available. I'm displaying the remaining fields information also. Click on edit columns inside the first.com quick access menu. Display the candidate ID, the location, and the contact number, email ID, and the position for which he has applied. And the notice period. Now let's save this one. We can able to see that information. Now these are the candidates has been applied for this position. Now Sandeep Kumar has applied for Tipco developer. Kiran Kumar has applied for the Salesforce administrator. And the Raghu P has applied for the Java developer. So these are the positions for which these candidates has been applied. Nothing but there are some parents are available. This position record is the parent and this candidate record is the child. Now come to the scenario. Suppose if I'm deleting this position record, what about the associated candidates? Now let's see here. Let's go to the TIBCO developer position here. Go to the positions. TIBCO developer. I am removing this particular position record here. Click on delete. Click on OK. I have removed the TIBCO developer. The record has been removed from this list. When you go to the recycle bin, Inside the recycle bin, this TIBCO developer record is available here. TIBCO developer record is available inside this recycle bin because this record has been removed. Now, come to the scenario. What about this associated child? For the TIBCO developer, one candidate has been applied. Okay, one candidate has been applied for this particular TIBCO developer position. So what about that candidate? So now refresh this one. Click on candidates. What about the candidate number? Where is that candidate here? Three candidates are there. Raghu, Kiran Kumar and Sandeep. Sandeep has applied for the TIBCO developer position. So now whenever I'm removing the TIBCO developer position record, automatically the associated child record also gone. Nothing but what happened in this case, what we have observed. Whenever I'm removing the parent record, then the associated child records are also will be getting removed by default. This is the functionality. So now when coming to the lookup association, we have observed when you delete the parent, only parent is deleted, child is existed as it is. But in the master detail, what will happen? Upon removing the parent record, the associated child records are also will be getting removed by default to you. So now, so this is observation. Let's make a note of it here. Upon removing the parent record, all the associated child records will get removed automatically by default. Automatically by default. This is observation here. The next one. When coming to the master detail associations. So now, how many master detail associations we can have per object? Maximum of two, not more than that. An object can have maximum of two master detail associations. An object can have maximum of two master detail association fields, not more than that is the limitation given by the Salesforce to you. An object can have maximum of two master detail associations inside this. The next one, the next observation. Let's go to that here. For example, if I'm restoring that position record, then what about the candidates? Will it be restored back? Yes. Now, let's see here. I'm going to be going for the recycle bin, selecting that position record here, TIBCO developer, click on undelete. So now the position record will be coming back. When you go to that positions, position record will be coming back, TIBCO developer. Whatever the candidates are there, those candidates will be getting come back again. Now let's see, when you go to that candidates list, you will be getting that Sandeep Kumar record again. Sandeep Kumar has been associated with TIBCO developer. Now here also we are going to be having that observation inside this. Once we restore the parent record, then all the associated child records will be restored back to the object. This is the observation that we have. Now, when coming to the master detail association here, the next observation is between that master detail association, sharing settings and security settings of the child record will be purely dependent on the parent record. That is, child record will be under the control of parent record. Child record will be under the control of parent record. That's what here. Okay, that's what here. When you go to the lookup association, let's see. Now, when you go to that lookup association, like as the positions and the hiring managers, I'm opening the positions and I'm opening the hiring manager. So there is a position is available here. Like as tip code developer. This position has been assigned to whom? Ayushi. Ayushi J. Go to the hiring manager, Ayushi J. So now Ayushi J, nothing but this is the hiring manager record, parent record, which is having the owner field. Which is having the owner field. When you go to that, the associated child record, nothing but the tip code developer, it is also having its own associated owner field. Okay, owner field. So now when coming to the Salesforce, always only owner will be having the rights to delete the record. Only owner will be having the rights to delete the record. Other people, they can see, they can able to modify your record, but to delete that, we should be the owner. Because without the owner permissions, we cannot remove the record from the instance. Why? Because if I am the owner, if you are a normal user, if you are deleting my record, then what about the security for my record here? There is no security. So for that here, always owner will be having the full control on the record so that he can able to do whatever the operation he wants on that record. That flexibility will be there. So now for that here. But when you go to that master detail, this is the position record that we have tip code developer. This tip code developer will be having one candidate called as Sandeep Kumar. Let's open that Sandeep Kumar record over here. I'm opening that Sandeep Kumar record. Now, when coming to the Sandeep Kumar record, do we have the owner field? Have you identified anywhere owner field over here? No. But when you go to that position, you will be having the owner field. You will be having the owner field is available here. So this is the owner field, training Salesforce user. Nothing but what happened, whenever you are having the master detail association, each and every child will be comes the control under of that parent record. Parent will be the owner. Okay, whatever the owner is available for the parent, so now the same owner will be applicable for that child as well. That's what here, if you're deleting the parent record, all the associated child records will get removed. Okay, now. The next one. The next option. When coming to the master detail associations, okay, when coming to the master detail associations, we can able to create, okay, we can able to create the role of summary fields. We can create the role of summary fields on the parent object. What exactly the role of summary field will be discussing in the next sessions over here. Now, so we can able to create that role of summary field on the parent object also, which is used to summarize that parent object, child object records based on the parent. Based on the parent record, we can able to summarize those child object records as well. That flexibility will be available to you as part of that role of summary field inside that. Now, so these are the various observations are available when coming to the master detail association. So this is the way we are going to be configuring that lookup association and we are configuring the master detail association. The next one, I will show you one small option, lookup filter configuration. lookup filter configuration. What exactly the lookup filter configuration? What is the use of this lookup filter configurations? Now we'll see practically here. For example, I am a candidate. We are having so many positions are available here. From these positions, assume that some positions are closed. Okay, some positions are closed. Like some TIBCO developer. This position has been closed because they have identified some resources so that they have closed this position. Okay, closed. So now when you go to that positions, this position has been closed. There is a closed position. But whenever a new candidate is going to be applying for the positions, when you click on lookup to select the position record, in this positions list, it is populating that closed positions information as well. TIBCO developer, which is a closed position. Is it the right information? No. As a candidate, we cannot apply for a position which is already closed. Already we have recruited the candidate. So we need no need of any other candidate for this position. Because already we did some interview process. We have identified some candidates. We have recruited the candidates as well. So that it should not be get displayed. The candidates cannot apply for a position which is already closed. So at that time, whenever you are trying to be selecting that position records, at that time, whatever the positions has been closed, those closed position records should not be get visible over here. Then how can we configure this one? Nothing but this is a lookup filter. This is a lookup dialog. Inside that lookup dialog, I'm going to be populating only those position records which are not yet closed. Okay, which are not yet closed. So now the unclosed position records I would like to display over here. The closed position should not be displayed over here. Now, then how can we configure? Now let's see here. So now this is a lookup dialog of what? Open positions. This is a lookup dialog of what? Open positions here. Let's go to that positions. Go to the first.com quick access menu. Click on view object. So now this is for the candidate, right? Now, let's go to the candidate. Go to the view object. Go to that master detail field, which we have. This is the position. I'm populating that position records. Open that position field by selecting that link. So now when you come down, you will be having that lookup filter. Okay, here's the lookup filter option is available. Click on edit button. You will be having that lookup filter section is available. Go to the lookup filter section. Expand that link, show lookup filter settings. Okay, expand that option, lookup filter settings. So now what do you want to do? I want to display only those position records which are not yet closed. The position records whose status is not closed display only those position records. The other position records don't display for me because it will be creating some ambiguity for me in the future. So for that, you can able to add that condition. How can we add? Go to that filter criteria. You can select the field, select the operator, and select the value. Based on that, we can able to add the conditions. Now I'm going to be adding the condition based on position status. Go to the object. Based on which object you would like to filter the records in the position object. In that position object, which records you would like to filter? Position record. Based on which field? Position status. So that select that field here, position status. Position status. In the position object, position status field, not equals to closed. Not equals to closed. Nothing but whenever it is going to be loading that position records inside that lookup dialog. So please filter those position records based on this condition. Apply this condition on every record. If the record is satisfying the condition, then only display that. So now please display only those position records whose status is not equals to closed. Now, if you want to show any message, then you can display that here. Now, please select the position name. Here also in the lookup dialog also we are giving the same name. Lookup window text. Please select the position name to be get applied. To be get applied. And make this filter as active in order to apply this condition on each and every record. Click on save button. So now here what I'm doing is go to that master detail field inside your child object. Go to that lookup filter section and expand that show filter settings link. It is providing that filter settings to you. Add your condition which you are going to be applying in order to filter that records. And then specify the lookup window text and click on save. Now we have added a filter condition over here. This is a filter condition. Please display the position record whose status is not equals to closed. Now, let's go to the candidate. Click on new. When you click on position link, it is populating only those position records which are not yet closed. See, the previously the position records which are closed, nothing but tip code developer, that position record is not visible to you. Why? Because that is already closed position. So that here that is not visible to you. So now in the lookup dialog, it is displaying some message to you. Please select the position name to be get applied. Nothing but we are displaying some lookup dialog, such a text name also here. Some label also we can able to display over here. That flexibility is available to you inside this. So this is the way we can able to filter the records which needs to be get displayed inside the lookup dialog as well. Instead of populating some all those records, we can able to populate only those records based on some certain conditions as well. That flexibility will be available to you. So this is the way we are going to be configuring the lookup dialogs, lookup filter configurations. This is very, very important, but generally nobody will discuss that. But when you enter into the actual real time, these kind of features are very, very important for us. Instead of writing some code to filter the records, we can able to filter the records by using these ready-made options given by Salesforce. Okay, now. So now do the practice on these features, whatever we have discussed today and the yesterday's session. In tomorrow's session, we are going to be discussing about the concepts called as relations among the standard objects. So what are the various objects that we have inside our Salesforce? Like as account, contact, and opportunity, case, and all those things, what is that association among those objects? And then, after that, we are going to be discussing about a concept called as converting the lookup relationship into master detail and vice versa. How can we convert the lookup into master detail? How to convert the master detail to lookup? What are the considerations that we need to have that we are discussing in tomorrow's session? And then we are going to be discussing about many-to-many association. How can we map many-to-many association? We'll see practically in tomorrow's session. That is also a very, very important feature. Definitely we'll be having a question how to achieve many to many association between the two objects, and then what are the various limitations given by the many to many associations we'll see in tomorrow's session. And after that we are going to be discussing about the concept called as roll up summary fields. Okay, so these are the features we are going to be planning for tomorrow. So do the practice on lookup and master detail so that you will get the complete idea. And difference between lookup and master detail is a common question in every interview. So that you should be ready with all the differences and the observations which we did as of now.